support and share this video as much as possible so that, you know, this does not happen to anybody out there. And thank you. Thank you so much for watching. So guys, my Zomato order was late and I was talking to the customer care executive, and meanwhile the delivery person just did this. He hit me, left me bleeding here and ran off. Please share this video with everyone. Guys, let me tell you the story, the entire story. I ordered food from Zomato because I was working since morning, and then I ordered around 3:30, which was supposed to get delivered by 4:30, and I did not get my order on time. So I was constantly, you know, following up with Zomato team, like either give me a free delivery for the same or just cancel the order, because this is not the thing. You promise something and you deliver something else. So that thing happened, and then the Zomato delivery guy came here. What he did was, he was so rude, he was so freaking rude. And because I have sushi with me, so I usually don't open my full door, so I was just talking him through a small slit from my door, and I just told him, bhaiya, you wait, because I need to check with the team, either they'll make it free or I don't want the order. And I already gave him the choice, like, you know, I don't need the order, so you just take it, I am okay. But he refused to take the order back, and then again he started screaming at me, bloody, I'm your slave or what? You are asking me to wait for such a long time, what the hell? And so it was really threatening for me, and I got scared and I tried shutting my door so that, you know, he could not harm me. But before that, he pushed the door, and he was so huge, he pushed the door and he just snatched the order from my table. That is, he entered my house and then he punched me on my face so that I don't get back to him, and he ran away. And sadly, you know, nobody in this premises care to hear anything happening. Nobody responds to any such thing happening. And being the single girl staying, it is so dramatic. Like, you know, people do not come up to you. So, which is insane. So, guys, after that thing happened, I am at the hospital. And this is my current situation. And it seems like after the x-ray, my bone is broken. So we need to do a surgery for the same, and I can't talk because the moment I start talking, my eyes are starting watering and nose starts bleeding. So this is the update as of now. Also guys, so when I started this video, that snippet is after I visited the hospital, so I had put in just pictures where you can see how badly I am bleeding and what my condition is literally. And I am able to talk right now just because I had been to the hospital and they gave me some high antibiotics and painkillers. Because of that, I am able to talk this much. And also, thank you so much for Bengaluru Karnataka police. Like, the police station I visited, they were like so humble and gentle, and they literally took care of my concern and they listened to me. And you know, I was so scared after the incident what happened, so they were like, till the time we are alive, madam, you need not worry about whatever is going on. So that's the update, and I have all the FIR copy and the, you know, doctor prescription where it says it is a major damage which has happened to me. And you know, you guys know me, like, I being an influencer and face for you guys, if this gets ruined for me, I don't know what next stands there for me. But I would love if you guys really support and share this video as much as possible so that, you know, this does not happen to anybody out there. And thank you so much for watching.